The pituitary gland has two lobes, an anterior and a posterior. In this section, we're going to talk about the posterior pituitary gland. It's also known as the neurohypophysis. Sometimes the pituitary gland as a whole is referred to as the hypophysis. So the posterior pituitary gland is this section here. The posterior pituitary gland is a direct extension of the hypothalamus in the brain. There are two nuclei within the hypothalamus that secrete their hormones into the posterior pituitary. And these are the supraoptic nucleus, or SON, and the paraventricular nucleus, or the PVN. So SON, PVN, supraoptic, and paraventricular secrete their hormones into the posterior pituitary gland. They're made up of, they're neuroendocrine cells or neurosecretory cells. So these are really special neurons. They look like neurons and they act like neurons to a large degree, but instead of synapsing with another neuron, their axon terminals here in the posterior pituitary release hormones. And the two hormones they release are oxytocin and vasopressin. And we'll talk a little bit more about those in detail in the next couple of slides. The supraoptic nucleus and the paraventricular nucleus here, kind of here and here, are made of or contain neurosecretory cells. And neurosecretory cells are neurons, but they, instead of synapsing on another neuron, they're simply going, when they're activated and they send an action potential down their axons, it's going to result, instead of the release of a neurotransmitter, it's going to result in the release of a neurohormone. And that neurohormone is then going to be released into the vascular bed of the posterior pituitary gland. The two hormones that are made by the neurons of the SON and PVN are oxytocin and vasopressin. Vasopressin is also known as antidiuretic hormone, or ADH. So oxytocin, secreted into the posterior pituitary gland, has effects on both the uterus and the breast, or the mammary gland. So during childbirth, oxytocin increases the contractility of the uterus to facilitate birth. And during lactation and during nursing, oxytocin causes the release of milk for the suckling infant. Vasopressin acts on the kidney. Vasopressin, or antidiuretic hormone. Diuresis is losing fluid, and that's, of course, what your kidneys do, is help you regulate your fluid balance. So vasopressin acts on the kidney to increase water absorption, so antidiuresis, antidiuretic hormone. It also acts on your sweat glands to decrease sweating. It inhibits sweating, and it contributes to constricting your arterioles. So vasopressin is another way of thinking of increasing your blood pressure. So oxytocin acts on the breast or mammary gland and the uterus. Vasopressin, or antidiuretic hormone, acts on the kidney, and both of these hormones are made in the supraoptic nucleus, the paraventricular nucleus. Both are released into the posterior pituitary capillary beds. In the next section, we'll talk about the anterior pituitary, how the hypothalamus regulates it, and then what the anterior pituitary, how it regulates the rest of your endocrine system.